Yeah, he flew it around on the 4th of July. He was trying to get, like, into the fireworks show and get the explosions from, like, a few meters away.
Thank you. Thank you.
Nice.
That's fucking cool.
Thanks, guys.
Yeah.
How much was your setup?
Well, I don't have all the gizmos on here because I have FPV and a bunch of other stuff, but just for the platform, the vehicle itself was like $750, and then, it gets expensive quick. GoPros and gimbals and all the add-ons are more expensive, but yeah, the frame and the brains and the GPS itself were about $750.
It's a lot cheaper than I thought it would
be. Yeah, it was a lot cheaper.
But then you, just
you build it yourself. If you build everything yourself, you don't have to pay like the DJI, they make the Phantom Vision 2. It's about $1,300 for the setup or whatever.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
This has tons more capabilities than that. I mean, this thing does a lot more than I'm comfortable with. Like, I can just tell it, I could have just had his droid, like any Android device, you can take out your phone, has the map of where you're at on GPS, and you can just scroll your finger and be like, I want you to do like a little lap around, and then just put waypoint 1 is takeoff, the last waypoint is land, put altitude at 0, and then you just give it a little gas and it flies itself and then comes back home and lands.
That's
just
really
like,
cool. Yeah.
But I'm like, I question everything. I'm like, should I turn it over to him? Like, I think I should control it a little more.
Well,
because
sometimes there's been a few waypoints that are in, South Africa? Or it wants to go to, South Africa. A
couple times where it's like, I do my little waypoint map, and I'm like, while I'm editing, it's like waypoint 2, and it's just a line that I can't even see, and I'm all, open the map up, and it's just all Mozambique. You're like, that's not
no,
it.
No, please don't go there.
Don't go there at all.
That's it.
That's bad news.
Cool deal.